Hello everyone, you're on SK Live. I'm your host Indradeel Basu. Today we have a very special guest, the former selector of BCCI, Mr. Gagan Khoda, also a former cricketer. Sir, good to see you. How are you?
I'm good, Indradeel. Good to see you too. I'm good. This lockdown has been special for me because, you know, as a selector, I was traveling so much. We were traveling about 290 in a year, I finished my tenure in March and the lockdown began. So with my kids, having a great time with them. And I'm cooking also. So I'm enjoying myself.
So it's been quite a time, you know, and spending with the family. Don't you think it's a huge relief that cricket has finally returned to England and we are going to have IPL and cricket is going to survive this turmoil, I guess?
It will. See, cricket, in my opinion, it has started after a gap of 4 months.
Yeah, and almost more than 100 days. Yes,
I've been watching. I watched England and West Indies play, and I'm watching England and Pakistan. So it's a big gap, and I think in India people worship cricket, and they can't have all these huge gaps. So I think it's going to turn in India, everywhere else.
And IPL starting somewhere in September, and November.
Yeah. It should. I think all the players who are playing IPL, it's a huge revenue generation for them. So I think IPL should happen.
And cricket is best watched, you know, when things are in whites, right? I mean, for a purist of the game, when people are playing in whites, nothing is more pleasing. That sight is nothing is more pleasing than that sight, isn't it?
Absolutely agree with you. Test match cricket is test match cricket. You cannot compare test match with anything else.
You know, this is something really special, but you have traveled so much as a selector. What you enjoyed the most, watching T20, ODI or Test Match Cricket?
Test Match Cricket, believe me. I love watching Test Match Cricket because that is where all your technique, all your planning comes in. Your adaptation to different conditions, that is what comes in. You have a moving track, when you go to Australia, you have a good bouncy track. When you go to New Zealand, the ball swings. So, in England, so, you know, it's fun seeing all the cricketers adapting to it, changing their game, changing their technique a little bit, and doing well there. So it's fantastic seeing Test match cricket. I think one day cricket, you all have flat wickets, you know, just come in line and hit the ball. It's more of a entertainer, I believe.
Absolutely. There's no two ways about it. Test match cricket is, when you play Test match, they call you, you know, they call you men. Otherwise, you know, it's it's small boys playing the shorter formats. But coming to your role as a selector, how challenging was it? I mean, there were a lot of questions being asked about, you know, Mr. Gagan Khoda didn't play test cricket, didn't play enough international cricket. But you have seen so much cricket and you've been quite a robust cricketer. You know, you played runs, you made runs in all formats of the game. So how challenging was it?
It was very challenging. See, there were a lot of people who were criticizing about the predictability. They all did.
Yeah.
But I feel, when you talk about a selector, the same as talking about a coach. A coach doesn't have to play much of cricket to be a great coach. Yeah. A selector, people like me, I've played more than 150 first class matches. And I've captained India twice. So I've seen a lot of cricket. So playing so much of cricket and only can be a good selector, I don't believe in that. I think all of us, all five of us did a creditable job. And I'm very, very proud of my team, which we had.
You know, last 5 years that you've been the selector, which was the best moment for Indian cricket?
Of course, when you won the Gavaskar Borough Trophy in Australia in Sydney, that was the best time. And I was there. Fabulous. Yeah. It was just like winning a World Cup. Amazing it was.
So what was special about, you know, we obviously, they said, you know, the Australian team didn't have the likes of Stephen Smith and David Warner. And that's why the team wasn't as strong as the Australian team is right now in world cricket.
These are all excuses. I feel they are the full bowling attack and we played brilliantly, we batted brilliantly and the way we were bowling, even if Smith was there or Warner was there, it wouldn't make a difference. I think we were playing outstanding cricket there.
Sir, but what went wrong then? You know, I mean, we did so well in Australia. Then we talk about South Africa, we talk about England, we talk about New Zealand. So,
you see, those are, I would say, a little bit tactical mistakes that we did in England and in South Africa, which we paid heavily for. But that is fine because, see, that is where you understand the game, you learn from it, and you become better. After those two series, we played in Australia and we won. So it became better.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And you know, one good thing about we went to South Africa, we went to England, but these places we actually fought. There was always a chance that we'll come back in those.
Of course, there was sometimes that you were winning, but somehow we lost. So it wasn't a one-sided affair. It was a good fight throughout in Australia, in South Africa, and England. It was a good fight throughout.
So that meek surrender we used to see earlier, in earlier versions, you know that.
I wasn't there. See, that was what I'm telling you. A team, like Indian team, which is right now, which is full of youngsters, and they all are doing very well. They come into the side, and what happened in South Africa and England, we learned from that. And we took it to Australia, and we won there. See, that is how you make a team. And we have a brilliant side right now.
And brilliant, talent pool you have, you know. How tough was it selecting those, you know, members for different formats?
No, it was difficult actually. But you know what? We had all these shadow tours, which was before the Indian tour. If you go into New Zealand, we had a shadow tour of India A team going there first. So all the players, India A players, used to play there. So by that, we actually selected, we had a great bench strength. That is what we did. The bench strength was so phenomenal. Any player who comes out of the Indian team and a player goes in, you won't make a difference. You won't even find out, oh, he's not there. You will not miss that player. So that is exactly what we did. We made a great bench strength. And that all happened because of the India tournaments that we had. All those going to Australia, going to South Africa, going to England, India tours. That helped us a lot.
We just got that impression that, you know, India, really, really solid at top of the order. 1, 2, 3 in the shorter format of the game, which is ODI cricket. And in the middle, there was a little bit of weakling. That's what everyone felt, you know, in and around the World Cup. So what are your thoughts on that bit? You know, the middle order wasn't that strong. That's what everyone said. You know, get 1, 2, 3 early and India will be in all sorts of trouble. So what are your thoughts?
No, I see. We wanted a number 5 player. And we did experiments, did everything. Nothing worked out. Actually, nothing worked out properly. So, because Hardik Pandya was injured and he was out for some reasons, as you know.
Yeah.
So, that continuity got finished. And then we had to find somebody at number 5 to play. Yeah, we got Ambati. Then Ambati had some issues. And we got one more player we got in. Nothing worked out. Then we got Kedar Jadhav, he was playing a good role at that number 5-6. And then we got Dinesh Karthik, because Dinesh Karthik was doing very well in T20 format. So I will not say that our middle order was weak, but yeah, it wasn't as strong as our first four batsmen. And any team, if the first four batsmen gets out cheaply, any team will struggle. It is not India. Any team will struggle. So it is wrong to say that if the four batsmen doesn't go get runs, India would struggle. Who won't, you tell me.
Absolutely.
Everybody will. So I think we had a good combination. Everything was good.
But you know, number 4 was debated for a long time. You know, ever since you saw Yuvraj Singh going out in 2017 after the Champions Trophy, there was 2 years of continuous struggle to get the number 4 slot. Now we have someone, thanks to you guys. But why was that struggle happening? Was it because Ambapathy Raidu was there? You said you had some little issues. So what was it like you are expecting them to score in every game? Is it possible humanly?
No, the thing was Ambati Raidu was experienced and you're looking at the World Cup.
Yeah.
So Ambati Raidu was there, we carried on with him for a year or so and then we felt that he's getting stagnant somewhere. And the confidence level going to the World Cup wasn't there. And then there was the World Cup. So we couldn't get any youngster with no experience in playing in England, of course. So no experience. So that is where I think Kedar did a good job there. Then we had Karthik coming in number 4. So it was fine. I never thought we were weak anywhere. This team wasn't weak. It was just one bad day we had. And that was it. Because that day the match didn't happen. The next day it happened. You know, the momentum finishes. You have to start all over again. So it happens.
It must have been very painful, you know, losing the semi-final. Because we were the tournament favourites. We had the team. We had the best, everything, you know, ammunition to counter the best of opposition. So, must be hurting India even now, 1 year later.
It must be. I was there only. I got very upset. But see, that's what the game is. You win, you lose. It's just a sport. You take it that. And I actually commend the Kohli and his team, they never showed it on their face. Never. They came out happy, never showed it on their face. So it's okay. It's hard to digest, but after all, it's just a sport.
Someone is asking from the reader, what about the selection of Vijay Shankar for the 2019 World Cup?
So we had to take two all-rounders to England.
Yes. Yeah.
That was necessary with Hardik and this thing. We had to take two.
Jadeja was the other all-rounder.
There was the spin all-rounder. We wanted somebody who can put in 2-3 overs. The ball moves out there. So they would have been effective.
Yeah. And he did. And he did prove himself in those matches when we played at home.
He batted well, he did well. Then he got injured, of course. He had to come back. He did well.
But during your time, I remember, Indian team was all about big cities, you know. The guys from, Bombay, Delhi, Karnataka. That was the composition. So now cricket has traveled all over the country. You know, you don't have to be from Bombay to play for India anymore. You can be from Kapurthala. You could be from anywhere, you know.
No, that's very true. In our times, I've never seen any selector coming and watching our match. Never. My entire career, they must have come twice at the most to see my match or our central zone match as such. Yeah. So, big cities, of course. That was, if you belong to Mumbai, Delhi or Tamil Nadu or all those cities, you were looked after. But of course, small cities, it used to happen in those days when I was playing, but not now. Not now, of course not. It is because of the selectors, because they're traveling so much. They're seeing so many matches. They're going everywhere and seeing matches. And the matches they see, I'm telling you, when we were there, it is not about getting runs or getting wickets. We used to go there, we used to see a person in what situation he's playing, where he's getting runs, what is the wicket like. You know, it makes such a lot of difference. And that is where all these guys come in.
Yeah.
Like, you see, it started from UP. How many players from UP came and played for India? Then, of course, Dhoni is the biggest example of all. In other place, Shami coming from a village and playing, all these guys. So that is because of the selectors going everywhere, watching so many matches and getting in new players to play.
Absolutely.
It wasn't there before, because if I played for 19 years and only twice the selectors come and watched our match, so you can really imagine.
It's a big joke. When was the time it actually changed when, you know, people started traveling? Which was that phase of Indian cricket? If you can recollect.
I don't remember, but I think after Saurav became the captain, it started with that.
Okay.
I think so. After that, started becoming, they all were traveling and doing all the stuff. But I think after Saurav became the captain, it all started.
And for all those who are watching, it's just to put everything on record. Mr. Gagan Kota has been a phenomenal talent as a youngster, scored heavily in all formats of the game, burst into domestic cricket with a debut century in 1991-92. So how do you look back at those days? When you think about,
I look back with no regret, because I did well. I did exceedingly well. I got runs wherever it mattered. But I didn't play at the highest level for a longer time. And that's not in my hands. So I look back with no regret. I'm very happy with what I achieved. I'm very happy with that.
But this is really surprising. Someone who makes his debut against Bangladesh, scores 29, gets another match, becomes man of the match with a score of 89. And then he never played for India. He just disappeared.
But I travelled with the team a lot. For 2 years I was travelling, didn't get a single match.
Did you bother to ask them, why you're not making me play?
See, that is the difference between then and now.
Okay.
Now you can ask. Now, when you're selectors, they used to come and ask us, sir, what went wrong? Why aren't we then the team? And we used to tell them, we used to discuss with them, and we used to tell them what exactly we want from you to be there. So that he knows where he has to work hard. In our times, we won't even get a chance to talk to them. Forget asking them. That's what I'm telling you. Everything has changed. The mindset has changed. Everything in cricket has changed completely.
And it's so important for a selector. It's so important for a selector to talk to the players and let him know.
Absolutely. Absolutely. If you're dropping a player who's done well, you're dropping him.
Yeah.
For a reason, because your other player, senior player, was injured. He came into the side because he wasn't there. He did well, but he came back, so he has to go. But no, we will talk to him. We'll tell him, you are in line. You are the next person in. Keep on working hard. This is where you lack. Work hard on that. See, that way, that person also gets motivated to do well. And I think this has to be the way.
And also, letting them know that you could be picked. I've seen so many times you had a word with Rishabh Pant, that he would be in, he would be out, whatever. You had always had a discussion happening with the players.
Yeah, I spoke to him in Australia. I always speak to him because I think he's a great talent. He's a great talent. The only thing is self-realization. Once he does that, he'll be a treat to watch. But he's superbly.
No, what do you mean by self-realization? He knows he's a big player.
He has to realize what he's capable of. He still doesn't realize his potential. Once he does that, then he'll be a different player altogether.
Did you have a word with him to make him understand?
Many times. Me, my colleagues, they all did.
So, I mean, and the push he's getting, despite, get that freedom to go out and express. And thanks to selectors like you, who created that bubble, you can go there and express yourself. That is phenomenal. But what exactly did you tell him apart from, realizing where you're going wrong and how you should improve on that?
I always talk to him about, you just be free. Do not have anything in your mind that you're going to get out or something like this. You play your game, but just your shot selection, you have to be careful. Nothing else. Sure. Just go on with it. So that is where he has to mold his game. And I feel he'll do it. I feel he'll do it. He's taking time, but he'll do it.
Talking about shot selection, I mean, some of your teammates and your counterparts against whom you played, they remember you fondly. You are the original hitman in domestic cricket. The kind of batting you did, what we are saying, what we basically see from Rohit Sharma these days. They really unfortunately didn't have a longish run. But tell me about those hitting abilities, during your days.
See, the thing was, it was something you had no choice, because the wickets you used to play on, they used to be right angle turners. So by staying on the wicket, you're bound to get out within an over or two. You were rank turner. Yeah. So the best way to defend is to attack. So I used to do that. So while doing that, it became a habit. On spinners, I used to play like this only. But there's no point defending. You just go there, you see, you step out and play, because that thing, now people don't step out nowadays because they get good tracks. So there's no need to step out.
Actually,
you can't stay on the wicket and play because the ball is turning so much, you never know where it's going to go. So the best thing is before you deliver, he's delivering, you reach to the ball and play. So when you do that, you start hitting. You don't go and defend. There's no point. So you start hitting. So that's how my game actually went like this only.
Attack is the best defense.
On those kind of tracks. And you used to get those tracks only.
Yeah.
For 7 years, I never played a medium pacer, 6 years, in my Ranji Trophy career. The only spinners, nothing else. Because we used to have central zone and south zone, all those stuff. Now we have the Dilip Trophy, zone-based Dilip Trophy used to have. So in our central zone, they were only spinners. You take MP, you had Hero Bhai, Chauzi, then you take Vidal, you have Pritam, then Murali Karthik in Railways. So there were spinners everywhere. So we always used to have turning tracks.
And for everyone's information, he used to treat Mr. Gagan Khoda used to treat all these top quality spinners like club bowlers.
No.
It's all on the record books, on the scorecards. We are not, fabricating anything. But one of your ONGC teammates, Mr. Firoz Ghayas, remembers you took a bat from him and once, and you loved that bat, and you scored a 300, triple 100 against South Zone. And that attack had Javagal Srinath, Venkat Esprasad, Anil Kumle, Venkat Pati Raju, Kawaljeet Singh, the off-spinner.
Not Kawaljeet,
okay.
Sunil Joshi, Raju, they all were there. Of course, Srinath, Venki, they were there. Yeah, I took the bat from him because I told him you don't need it. So I just told him when your batting comes, that means the match is over. So you don't need a bat. So I took it from him. I got a triple in that. And I still have that bat with me.
Oh, wow. And you promised him you're going to return that bat to Mr. Ghayas. You haven't.
The same thing I'm telling you again. He never needed it then. He doesn't need it now also. So what is the point of giving it back to him?
But how was it playing the Dilip Trophy those days?
Fun. It was fun. It was so competitive. It was zonal-wise, no?
Yeah.
Zonal-wise was much more competitive. Because you're playing for a zone. it was fun. It was great fun. And Central Zone was the strongest team that time. And Dilip and Deodhar both.
And crowds came in to watch those matches.
Not much. Yeah, of course. When we played in Aurangabad, there was a lot of crowd in Aurangabad. That was the worst cricket I ever played in my life. And yeah, in small cities, used to get crowd in small cities, but not in big cities.
But you know, these stars like Srinath, Anil Kumble playing these matches, it made a lot of difference those days. But we don't see stars playing domestic games these days.
They don't have time. You tell me, where do they have time to play domestic matches? They don't. They only play a domestic match if they're injured. To come back on the side, they have to play a domestic match to prove their fitness. They don't have time now to play domestic matches. Previously, Anil and all these guys, they had time. But now there's no time. And you can't exert your players so much because they've been playing all three formats. They're playing IPL. They're playing everything. So you can't just ask them to play domestic. It's too stressful for them.
Is it mandatory to play to play domestic to prove your form?
To prove your fitness, of course. If you're injured, you're coming after an injury like Bumrah did. He had a back surgery done. So he came after that and he had to play a match. He had to play a 20 over match. Bowl about four or five overs in that to prove his fitness. See, it is very important. You know, it shouldn't happen what happened to Shardul Thakur. He came from an injury, bowled his first over in test match and he got injured. That shouldn't happen.
Absolutely. And you know, coming back to these injury bit, we you know, what was good about the selectors was they always had a backup. Whosoever got injured, there was always someone coming and doing the job for India and that person performing, and that increased your headache, right?
It did, but it made us happy also, because that's exactly what I was saying. We created a great bench strength. So whenever somebody was injured from the Indian team, this guy will go in and you won't even miss the other guy who got injured. So that was the beauty about this. But yeah, headache, you're right. If he does well and then other guy comes in and he's out, so that's a big headache. But that's where you speak to him, you make him understand. That is very important.
And you have gone through that domestic grind. You know what it takes to play international cricket. So that also helped, right? Going and talking to players who are doing well at domestic cricket.
Yes, of course. I spoke to Mayank also, Mayank Agarwal. He got so many runs in domestic, but it was hard to get him in because Shikhar and they were doing a great job. But when they failed, he came into the side and he did superbly.
Superbly, so, really.
I feel a player should have at least 2 to 3 years of domestic cricket in him to play for the country, before playing for the country. He should have at least 3 years of domestic cricket.
In fact, there were a lot of questions being asked why Mayank is not part of the team. He's scoring so heavily, but there was no score for him to put him in, right?
See, that is what you have to understand. Writing something for, see, Mayank is not getting any chance in spite of scoring so much. It's just common sense. If Murali and Shikhar are doing well, top order, where is this place? There's no place.
Absolutely. You know, I mean, we talk about Dhoni, we talk about Virat. You've seen that shift of captaincy, you know, when Dhoni gave that shorter format captaincy to Virat. And so, can you just tell us their style of functioning? I mean, how Dhoni was as a captain, how Virat was as a captain. Your thoughts on them?
See, I'll tell you. They say Virat is very aggressive.
Yeah.
Dhoni is not. I don't believe in this. See, aggression is not by, you know, being very vocal on the field. That is not aggression. Dhoni was aggressive. Plus, Dhoni was very, safe also at times. He was both. And you have to be safe as a captain. So, he was aggressive and safe. Kohli is aggressive. Now, he's learning and he's learning very quickly how to be safe in different circumstances. He's learning it very quickly. And the only difference between both is Virat is very vocal on the field. He's very vocal. Dhoni is not. He's not vocal. But that doesn't mean he's not aggressive. He's equally aggressive, but he's not vocal. That is the only difference. Dhoni was a great captain. I think he was a great captain. He used to study the game very well. You know, I spoke to him a couple of times in New Zealand and Australia. I think his work ethic was clearly superb. And he used to imagine the game very well, what is going to happen. And Kohli, same, is getting there. And Kohli is a very quick learner. He's a very quick learner. He'll admit his mistake. Okay, I've done this wrong. And I'll do better next time. So he's learning very quickly.
So what do you mean by safe? I'm being safe on the field.
In certain positions, you have to be safe. You can't attack all the time. You cannot be aggressive all the time. So depending on the situation where you are in a match, you have to be safe sometimes. Dhoni was a blend of both. Kohli is reaching there. Of course, he's reaching there.
So we somehow feel that, you know, Virat is expecting a result out of every delivery. Well, Dhoni played that waiting game. As you said, you know, Virat is a quick learner. He's learning the tricks of the trade.
That's experience. Even it'll come to Virat also. That's experience.
So in selection meetings, who was more vocal?
Nobody was vocal. See, you don't need to be vocal. We all played together.
Yeah.
And all of them are very well educated. All of them are. So there's no need to be vocal. We used to have discussions. Of course, we had arguments also. But it never went ugly. Never, ever it went ugly. So
nobody was vocal. Okay. I mean, you know. Sorry, you were saying something. Sorry.
I'm saying, please go ahead. Yeah.
I'm saying that, you know, there were a lot of reports also during that phase when you know 16, 15, 17, that the selectors are overpowered by the team management, because selectors, they don't come with, you know, 100 test match behind them. So that was, you know, that was the thing. They didn't have much of a say. It was only the team which were deciding the squad. It's not, selectors were just, you know, sort of puppets. So can you just clear out that position? You know, selectors, of course, work so hard. It's a thankless job.
It was nothing like this. Of course, selector is a thankless job, indeed. Yeah. But it was nothing like this. I've been there. See, when you select the team, it is only the captain who's there. We discuss with him. And, you know, he wants this. He tells us, if you can, I want him. I want this combination. We think about it. If you think it's right, we give it to him. If you think it's not right, then we don't give it to him. The final decision is, and never ever have we been compromised, nothing like this. And not even pressurized by team management to do something which we wanted to do. It has never happened. Team was made by us, 16-member team squad was made by us. And when we are traveling with the team, 11 is made by them. So there was never this that what they wanted, we do that. That is all false, absolutely.
No, I mean, when such reports came out, so what did you guys discuss among yourselves?
Nothing. We never used to care about it. Why care about something which is not true? It was just a waste of time discussing. We never ever cared about it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, they, let them talk. You can't stop them from talking.
Of course.
But Virat was, I mean, when there were little, you know, it can happen in any meeting. If there was any disagreement at any point of time, so was there any sort of misunderstanding which happened between selectors ever with the team with the captain and the selectors? Because in the past we had the captain differing with the selectors in a different way. And
no, see, arguments do happen. They do happen.
Yeah,
it's bound to happen. That's natural.
Yeah,
but that's what I said. It never went ugly, and the argument never went to a disagreement that they're not giving me this. Nothing of that happened. Kohli is a very sensible guy. And he's open to suggestions. And we just talk to him what we want. We make him understand. And it has never happened that he'll come and say, no, I don't want this. Never, ever. Because I think what we said and what we asked him to have a team, he wanted the same. 90% he wanted the same. There was never an issue. Never an issue.
You know, there were days when, you know, Indian team still did practice that horses for courses policy. So, frequent chop and change used to happen. So, do you think that was the reason we couldn't settle on a good, you know, core team which was very important for the World Cup?
I think nothing of this. I think we had a great team for the World Cup. I'm telling you, it was one bad day. The match didn't happen that day. Next day it happened. Everything was new. It was start all over again. So it was just one bad day we had. Otherwise, you played like champions. Throughout the semi-final, you played like champions. So we had a great team. Just unfortunate that we couldn't win the World Cup. And it happens.
it can happen, of course. And then there are moments, you know, I mean, we see the big teams. Now we are seeing a different setup in England that, you know, 4 to 5 players in all successful teams, they used to play all formats. Whereas in India, only 3 players were seen doing that. You know, Virat, Rohit Sharma and Bumrah, Jasprit Bumrah.
Jadeja is playing all 3 formats.
Jadeja is right now playing, yes.
Playing all 3 formats. Bumrah is playing, Virat is playing, Rohit is playing. And Shikhar was not injured. He was playing all 3 formats.
So we have 5
players. Hardik Pandya was playing all 3 formats.
So you think,
players were playing all 3 formats.
But you think the pool should increase the number of players playing all formats? Is it possible?
It is not possible because you need spinners for test matches. You need openers for test matches. Middle order, of course. So test matches is totally different for one day and T20s. A person is good in T20s or one day, not necessarily going to be good in test matches.
Absolutely.
In the case of Yuvraj, you know, these guys were super with white ball. They were never good test match players. They never proved themselves in test matches. So test matches team, even if you have 4 to 5 players who are playing all 3 formats, I think you're fine. You can't have more than that.
You can't play more than that. But, you know, what was the role of the selectors when they travelled with the team once they had selected the team? I mean, did you have a say in the selection, you know, of the playing 11? What was your role travelling with the team then?
See, I'll tell you, when I joined in 2016,
yeah.
That time we went for the Asia Cup to Bangladesh, I remember. So me and MSK were there. That time we used to have a formal meeting before the match.
Okay.
One day before the match with the coach and the captain to decide the playing 11. It was the same. We just used to give advice. If they want to take it, they take it. If they don't take it, they don't want to take it. Fine. But it was a good discussion we used to have. Finished. But after the Doda Commission, this thing finished. That a formal meeting with the selectors, it wasn't there anymore when you're traveling with the team. But yeah, we used to discuss, but it wasn't formal. Informal discussions to have. That is the only thing we have while they make a playing 11. Nothing more than that.
But you know, the selectors, the sort of job you guys did, it's also looking that India is going to go the England way. You know, England is playing the ODI cricket also and also playing Test cricket at the same time. You think Indian team will have this thing will happen in days to come because we missed out so much of cricket. We'll have 2 teams playing 2 different formats at some point.
2 teams playing 2 different formats.
Yeah.
No, I don't think so. You can't have 2 teams for 2 different formats. No, not possible.
But England is doing it.
They might be doing, but it's not possible in India.
Because you need a Virat Kohli whenever India is playing.
They want to see Virat Kohli in all 3 formats. You want to see Rohit Sharma in all 3 formats. So it is difficult in India. You can't do that.
Yeah. So how painful was it for Rohit Sharma to have missed out on the World Cup win? Because he did phenomenally well with 500s. He was outstanding as a performer. He's just simply great. I mean, what are your thoughts?
He played brilliantly. It was 500s of fabulous. You can't get 100 in each and every match. So, if you ask me personally, I would have loved him to peak later, not in the initial phase. But that's not the case. But yeah, it must be painful for him because getting 500s and he was looking in tremendous form. And actually, all of them were. So you don't talk about that match. That's over. That's finished.
Yeah, that's true.
But you know, very good.
Absolutely. And the upcoming assignment we have is of course the Australian tour. Hopefully it should happen, and hopefully we will repeat what we did a few years ago. And what are your thoughts on, because we are away from the game for such a long time? So
that is my worry. My biggest worry is the fitness of bowlers, because we won there because of our bowlers.
Yeah.
If you want to win a test match, you have to take 20 wickets. And we won because of Shami's brilliant bowling, Bumrah, all these guys, they bowled brilliantly. I'm just worried about the fitness level. Nothing else, because they have been away for what? Nearly 4 months now, 4.5 months now. Yeah. So coming back and training and getting that match practice before that big tournament, big tour, I don't know. But they just have IPL. And after that, they'll go for the Australian tour. I don't know. Fitness is fitness and match practice is my main one.
Yes. And you know, the main.
If you're playing in India, it wouldn't have been a problem. But going there and playing, I don't feel so good about that.
But the selectors need to be complimented the way they rotated the fast bowlers. My God, it's been done so well and with such systematic rotation. We have never seen, and that's why we can see them, you know, staying at that level from 2016 onwards, that level of the competence which our fast bowlers is showing in all formats, which is phenomenal. And I think selectors, as we know, is a thankless job, but selectors need to be complimented. How you planned it? Can you tell us how you planned these matches for these fast bowlers?
No, it was basically, we thought there were programs for all these fast bowlers, and we had a pool of about 5-6 fast bowlers. We thought we were going to rotate depending on their how much they are bowling and how much stress they are taking on their back and on their shoulder, everything. So, and the physios and the trainers, they helped them a lot. So, we used to get mails from them saying, okay, fine, he has to be rested and all. So, we used to get another one. So, that was decided by the BCCI, and of course, Rahul Brevet was there at the NCA. We got advice from him also. And of course, the physios and the trainers played a very important role in this, keeping them fit, and they feel they can break down any time. The meal is to come to us and is to give him rest, get another one in. So, you have to do this because the bowlers can't take so much of stress. Because they are playing IPL, they are playing one day, T20s and test matches. How much can a bowler bowl?
Absolutely. And the way you guys...
A bowler, you had to do this. And it worked. It worked.
It worked like a magic. And you know, how strong was Rahul Dravid's influence, as India A coach under 19 and then coming at NCA?
You don't have to ask me this, boss. Don't you know?
No, but you know...
He's one selfless person I ever seen. He's brilliant. The way he's handled the under-19 team, the way he's handled the Indian A team. I've traveled the Indian A team. I've seen it. The way he talks to the players, the confidence that he inculcates in a batsman or a bowler, it's fabulous. No, I'll tell you one instance. I was in Australia and they were playing Australia A in Brisbane. It was a green track. And he won the toss. He said, if you win, you have to bat. I was a bit surprised. Why would they need to bat on a green top? So I just asked him, why do they have to bat on a green top? I'm here because they have to learn. They have to learn to bat in any given situation. It's a green track, they should bat first. So it was, India tours was not about winning or losing for them. It was about the players, they should play in each and every condition. It was only about improvement of players. Fabulous, that was. Jam has done super work. All these guys, Manish Pandey, Hardik Pandey, all these guys have been trained by him.
Even some people are asking Manish Pandey, sir, what are his chances of playing regularly? You know, why is he not giving regular chances?
He's been playing now.
Yeah,
Manish has been playing in T20 and one day both.
Yeah.
So whenever somebody is not doing well, he'll come in. But he's there in the 15-member squad, so he'll get a chance anyways.
Absolutely. Tell me something, your interaction with the Indian coaches, the Ravi Shastris and the Bharat Aruns, they have been also quite phenomenal, like the selectors are doing. Their job is also, I think, thankless. The people don't understand what kind of hard work they put in behind the scene.
He's written about them also, no? No, I feel all those guys, I've been with Bharat, our bowling coach, I think fabulous.
Yeah.
They are thorough professionals. No, the net session is not about just coming to the net, batting, bowling and going back, no. They have a complete this thing for each and every bowler. Boss, you have to come today, you have to do this, you have to do that. For each and every bowler, he has that. And it's perfect work for an hour and a half with the bowlers. Same as fielding. I think we have become the best fielding side in the world.
Yes.
I think Sridhar has done a fabulous job.
Yeah.
And he works very hard. Which you see the sessions that they take. Fabulous it is. I speak to them. They say, no, today I'm doing this. And I want these players to be good in slips and also they go for slip catching, then outfield, everything. Everything is planned. They're very professionals, all of them.
Tell me something, is this team management or the selectors put a lot of stress on the nets? When they go in the nets, I mean, is it batting, how you bat in the nets, is it giving a lot of importance before a team is picked?
No. See, I'm telling you, it is not as it used to be. If you bat well in the nets, you're going to be there for the match. No, it is not this. They just plan something for the nets. Okay, the wicket is like this. I'm going to play like this. It's going to be bouncy. I'm going to a couple of balls. And you have bowling bowlers like all these guys. They bowl without this thing. What do you call that thing? I forgot. They bowl with that. And they bowl short pick bowls. So they have to leave it. So they come with a plan. It's not this. You have to bat fully in the nets. No. They come with a plan. And they just do that only and go back. So I'm telling you, it's done very professionally. It's very nice. So it's good to be a part of that total team management when you travel abroad and you see all of them doing that. It's very nice.
Like when you played, when you batted in the nets, what was your drill like? Did you tell yourself, I'm not going to get out in the nets? So how did you develop that temperament?
That was the only thing you were taught. If you go to the nets, do not get out.
Yes.
That was what we were taught. And you should do that only. Yes. Things have changed. Things have changed a lot.
Yeah, because you know, the moment that rush of blood comes that I have to hit the ball, you just take a walk, come back and again bat. That's the best way.
Yeah. It is. It is. And it works.
Yeah. It really works. Yeah. Yeah. Can you tell us one untold story from your career and which left a very positive imprint in your life, something you think about and you smile and something really funny?
Oh, no, don't get me into this, Narendranil. No, okay, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
I was leading India, we went to Pakistan.
Okay.
Ajit, MSK, Jatin, they were playing under me. And I got a lot of runs in that series. I got a lot of runs. So I came back and I was told that you please be ready, you send your passport. It was a West Indies tour, India West Indies. So I was very happy, I would be there and all. I got ready, I got my blazer, everything. And a couple of days, they said, no, you're not going. Someone else is going.
Oh, and God.
And don't ask me who that person was. Don't ask me that.
No, but you have been a brave, brave cricketer. You know, I mean, the way you turned up every day in white, the way you scored runs, you never let it go. You never said, you know, I'm going to get finished. No, you kept coming back with those big scores. And unfortunately, there wasn't anyone to push you that hard. There wasn't a Saurav Ganguly probably, you know, could have done a little wonder in your life.
That, if he was there, yeah, he would have pushed me. He would have supported me, actually. Not pushed me. He would have supported me. That's what you said, though. No. When you look back, what do you think? I think I have no regrets. I did what I could possibly do. So, no regrets. I'm very happy.
So, what's your plan right now? I mean, what you're now being a selector. Obviously, you're a professional. Yeah. You're the popcorn with me.
These 3-4 months off, and I'm actually loving my job in ONGCA. I've joined corporate communication.
Yeah.
So I joined purposely because I learned something from there. It's very creative, something new for me. So I'm loving that.
And any plans to come back to cricket field in as a coach or a commentator? You have any plans? Such plans?
Yeah, I have plans. I might do this. Let's see. Let's see how it works out.
But you were amazing as a selector. You always had that smile on your face. It was so brilliant. And for the cricketers who interacted with you, I can imagine what positive vibes you must have given as a selector, as a player, as a teammate. You were amazing, really. And it was really, really a pleasure having you as a guest. It was really a pleasure. And you said everything from bottom of your heart. You answered every question of mine. It was really, really great.
That's the way I am.
Yeah, absolutely. That's the way you batted also. Thanks a lot for coming on SK Live. It was a real pleasure. Thanks a lot. And stay safe, stay happy. And see you very soon when things improve around us.
Thanks for coming, Ranir. Stay safe.
Stay safe, sir. Thank you.
Bye. Bye.